chop all these siege tanks now. Those drones really desperately trying to run for their lives. There's
gaming.
Original StarCraft, and they're like, yeah, Marines, they suck. And I'm like, well, you use medics. They're like, what's a medic? And I was like, you don't know what a medic is? How do you play StarCraft? And then they're like, yeah, StarCraft.
Lurkers are so OP. Why would I buy Brood War? And I'm like, what?
What?
Lurkers. Lurkers.
And anyways, we're fantasizing about units that we'll never see in Wings of, StarCraft 2 Wings of Liberty. And let's get into this game here. We have Puck versus Titan here on, I believe this is Daybreak.
Yeah, this is going to be GSL Daybreak. So Titan spawning as the Red Zerg in the north and Puck as that Teal Protoss in the south. And I like this map. We see it a lot played in GSL. And I think it can be a fun macro map. You can take advantage of timings with your opponent, typically going for a fast expansion. So we'll see if either of these players really have a build set up for this. Again, this is a map that they don't have a lot of practice on if they spend a lot of time laddering.
Yeah, this is definitely one of those maps, and perhaps Titan purposely chose this map knowing that he has had more time to, say, practice on this over Puck. Titan, I believe, did get the map choice in this particular game, as we now see probes are making their way out. They are going to be doing a bit of scouting, and I'm trying to remember, I believe we saw this this map at MLG Providence as well during the first four games on Friday.
Yeah, I think it was part of the maybe the MLG. It was the Global Invitational. But I'm not sure it was played in the regular MLG. I forget whether there were any specific games.
Yeah,
but I see it often in GSL.
Yeah, definitely see it often in GSL. As Titan now going into a spawning pool first build, so he's most likely going to be getting pool and then followed by another hatchery, pretty much knowing that Puck is not going to really be able to block it with a pylon or a probe, as there will be four Zerglings just to push that one probe away, and then we should be getting some early queens, as Titan does generally like macro style games. Meanwhile, in the base of Puck and has gone for an assimilator and a front door gateway, most likely followed by a Cybernetic Core with a Zealot on the front door to prevent any units from walking or slipping by.
And interesting, typically Titan goes for pool and then gas, and almost in all matchups he goes for that early speed, but has yet to throw down a gas, so he might be going for some sort of three hatch, very quick play, and he has yet to know that Puck is not fast expanding, which is a pretty popular build for Protoss on this map. The choke point you have to defend at the bottom of that ramp, not too big. So I think that once Titan sees that he is not fast expanding, he might throw that gas, might not get that third quick hatch.
Yeah, we'll see. Now we have six Zerglings on the field, so that's a little bit more than I was expecting. Normally, there's only four on the field at any given time. As the Zerglings now make their way out, they're going to try to catch up to that one probe in the Zelnaga Tower here. The Zelnaga Tower doubly covered in vents here, as that probe taking a lot of damage. Now no more shields. Going to slowly take damage here as the Zerglings scour the map for any possible proxy pylons. That's always one of the things that you hate about Protoss, where you move out and you forget to scout if there's any proxy pylons, and all of a sudden you have four Zealots knocking at your front door when you have Zerglings at your opponent's base.
Yeah, really crisp and good play from Titan. This is the what could be the last game of Wednesday Night StarCraft. He does not want to lose to Cheese, does not want to lose to an unscouted proxy pylon. And now he's going to be poking in here. He's going to see that there's no fast expand. So far, this is going to be his first glimpse at the base. And he's saved up quite a bit of minerals, so he could throw down a fast third. But now that he sees the one base, I imagine he's going to be spending those minerals on maybe a second gas or maybe an early Evo chamber or just a ton of drones on his two base.
Yeah, so it's most likely going to be two bases. As you mentioned, you can already see a lot of drones being trained. I believe a creep tumor was established. So Titan going to quickly connect these bases here. No metabolic boost, but there's going to be a queen versus, I believe, a stalker. The queen is not armored, so this is going to be an interesting matchup, as the queen could get some easy damage and now try to back up onto the high ground as a third queen now being added. The queen going to make her way back up there as the Zerglings now back off. Zerglings running past the stalkers here, and this is going to be interesting as the creep tumors really need to connect these bases and in a hurry.
Yeah, we see the puck is scattered. There is no gas, so he knows that Zergling speed not going to be done for quite a while. So Zerglings off of creep, very, very slow, especially against Stalkers without that speed. So puck taking advantage, putting some damage on this hatchery. We've got three Stalkers now, and Titan's going to have to choose a moment here where he attacks with his queens, defends with these lings, and puck might be able to get away from this one without any damage.
Yeah, oh, Titan accidentally transfused with the, or sorry, injected with the one queen that actually had 50 energy. I think that was a little bit of a mistake there. Won't be able to transfuse as Titan's hatchery now down to half life. More Stalkers coming in, but the Zerglings are going to get in a good surround here, and the Stalkers are going to be forced to retreat. They are getting pinned up against the back here. One Stalker taking a lot of damage. That one Stalker seems a little bit confused, doing a Dragoon impression as the puck, as Puck Stalker now backing off there down to 8 hit points.
And speed's still not any closer to finishing. He's got about 30 in-game seconds, so he cannot lose this hatchery. We'll see whether Puck is able to focus this down. Now with four Stalkers, that hatchery could go down in about 10 seconds. It's down to about 20% health, down to about 15, now 10% health, pulling all these drones. And if he focuses down this hatchery, it could go down. That hatchery, 3 HP. He needs one more shot. He gets it. And Puck can retreat with these three Stalkers. Titan says missed. And now Titan's going to be really far behind. Puck already established his own natural. And Titan, I feel at this point, really needs to throw down a third quickly. But that speed, not having it, really hurt him against those Stalkers.
Yeah, I was waiting for that transfuse. And I know that Titan knew that he really needed to hit it. And by not hitting it, it really hurt him in the long run. Titan now wandering around with this Overlord doesn't see the Stargate. And this is going to be a problem as well, as he's going into Roaches. Roaches obviously not very good against Void Rays. Drones now doing a bit of that walk of shame, trying to get back into this, as we are now sitting on 36 probes versus 46 drones. So the drone advantage still very much in favor of Titan, but will he be able to fend off the next attack is going to be the key question. He's not activating the Zelnaga Towers. I'm not quite sure why, as he would be able to spot these Void Rays coming in.
Yeah, second Void Ray being chronoed out here, and it will join its brother a little bit late. We do already have a number of queens out, three queens, so they will be able to handle these Void Rays, spending a lot of that extra energy that they wanted to use on Transfuse on these creep tumors. So Titan going to be spreading creep. A smart move by Puck immediately checks that third. So if Titan had thrown down a third quickly, like I said, he might have needed to, it would have been taken down by the Void Rays, or maybe taken down very low, and Titan can't afford to lose any more hatcheries.
Yeah, taking a look at the total losses. The total losses are actually fairly even right now. 700 compared to 675. Harvester count, 47 compared to 49. So really, Titan is not that far behind. If he can set up a macro hatch, which he is already doing, he's very much in this game. And Puck, if he doesn't realize that Titan isn't too far behind, may be banking on his previous victory, which really, in the long run, wasn't that much.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like Titan did lose several minutes there of mining, so he is behind. At this point, you'd want to be about 10, maybe even 12 food, 15 food ahead of your opponent. And you're definitely still on two base against two base Protoss. That's not a good position. We see double forge coming from Puck, so he's going to be coming with some sort of timing here with upgrades. He's got Blink on the way as well. So if he chronos out these upgrades, he could come with a very nasty two base push here with Void Rays and Blink Stalkers.
Yeah, and in this time, very interesting, Titan also opened up the front door here by taking down these destructible rocks, so that ramp is now very, very wide open. The Void Ray is going to try to come back in. There is two queens and a Spore Crawler coming in, and the queen should be able to push away those Void Rays once more, but Titan is behind 77 over 78 compared to 94 over 108, and now with 59 probes, 60 probes versus 46 drones, I think Puck may be able to run away with this with some two-base timing attack.
It was about 75 to 75 for a few seconds there, and then suddenly Puck shot up. Titan was forced to spend drones making spore crawlers and money making spore crawlers instead of drones. He got up that third, and he's got good creep spread, so he's going to be able to protect that third against Void Rays, but I'm not sure we'll be able to protect it against the upcoming timing attack. It's going to be 1-1 with Blink Stalkers as well as a few Void Rays thrown in there. The one Void Ray is just down to about half health, but all have full shield, so this is going to be a very, very tough timing for Titan to defend against. He's got Roaches, he's got Lings, and he's got a Banelingness on the way, as well as Hydra range. So if he actually goes pure Hydra, he might be able to defend this attack.
Yeah, pure Hydro may work out well. We also saw the Ventral Sacks already upgraded and now going into a Baneling's Nest. Pneumatized Carapace has already been upgraded as we now see the Void Rays making their way into the third base and the Spore Crawler will not be ready in time. There is a Queen now coming over. The Queen just hanging around. This one Queen gonna take a lot of damage. Transfusion should be coming in, but there's too many Queens. And there you go. There's another Inject as another Overlord gonna get shot out of the sky. Puck just... hunting overlords like it's overlord season. 72 probes versus 62 drones.
So Puck going for a robotics facility at this point, maybe going to do some sort of tech switch. I'm not sure if he has seen the Hydralis Den or the Hydras. He has not at this point. And Titan coming out with a few Hydras. He's going to have about 8 on the field in just a moment. And I feel like those 8 Hydras plus any reinforcements he makes as he scouts any sort of push from Puck should be able to defend against the 1-1 blink stalker timing from Puck. So Puck, being a smart player here, expanding to a third, he's again going to be on even bases with his Zerg opponent. So Titan's still behind here by about 8 food, and at this point you want to be up about 20 food as a Zerg and up a base as well.
Yeah, so he needs to find out and figure out where he's going to establish his third. His fourth. He does have a really strong creep highway though, and with Hydralisk, that is very important as the Hydralisk get a 50% movement speed off of creep. On creep. And that is going to help him in the long run, but we also see the robotics bay coming in. So we're going to see Baneling carpet bombing, roaches. This is going to turn into a very heavy macro game, and it's really going to turn into a game to see who can replenish their units more quickly. Overlords now doing a bit more scouting as we now see Puck also warping in another proxy pylon over here. And it looks like the base is just being saturated very quickly. And I'm curious to know whether or not Titan purposely built this creep tumor straight in the middle of this mineral field and whether or not he's going to have to take it out in order to do any mining at that center base.
And Puck doing a nice job here. He has swapped over to Robotics Bay. He's going to be coming out with Colossi, Extended Thermal Lance already on the way. So I'm not sure if he knows he had forced Hydras there, but we've got a number of Lings and Banelings coming in for a Carpet Bomb here. We'll see how much damage along with Roaches they're able to do. A big drop in Puck's main. They're going to focus down this Robotics Bay immediately, so that's going to stop the Colossi production. That's going to stop Extended Thermal Lance, and we've got a lot of Banelings, and we've got a lot of probes here, and the Banelings looking to do some damage. Only 4 probes killed so far. Now up to 12 probes. Another Baneling does go off. That's 13 probes and no Robotics Bay focused down yet.
Yeah, the Robotics Bay was down to 150 hit points, and for some reason it wasn't destroyed as the Roaches are now going to go after probes. There's not much they can do. They know that they can't escape out going after probes. It looks like a lot of workers have been killed as Titan up to 16 worker kills now. And now we'll see how everything's going to work out as those Roaches still trying to battle it out. Stalkers get in the surround, but this did buy Titan some precious moments. Harvester count 65 to 64. Now evening things up a little bit as he does establish his third base.
Why would you not make sure the Robotics Bay goes down? That would have stopped Extended Thermal Lance. That would have delayed any push by Puck for, you know, at least another 5 minutes. He has to make the Robotics Bay. He's got to make, and that halts his Colossi production. Once it does come up, he's got to wait again for Extended Thermal Lance. And now he just has to make a robotics facility. He can start with those the Colossi once again. He could even go double Robo. I guess this is giving an opportunity for Titan to take that fourth, but Titan, I think a little bit of a misstep there.
Well, right now Titan trying to take a playbook out of the take a play from the Terran playbook, attacking at the third base and now also dropping in the main base once again. And we'll see how much damage he's going to be able to do. The Protoss Death Ball can only be at one place at one time. And now the Death Ball is being split up a little bit more. Zerglings running rampant. Robotics Bay has been taken down. And it looks like Pylons are going to get taken down. Are we going to have a tactical retreat? Puck does have a lot more food right now. And a retreat is in order as the Stalker should be able to blink underneath and take down some of these units.
Yeah, again, I think Titan could have done a little bit better job focusing things down. We see a Nexus at half health. We see an Assimilator with half his shields gone. We've got a lot of very low pylons. If you focus those Hydra and Zergling attacks on specific buildings, forges, robotics bays, things like that, you can take down very precise buildings, do a lot of damage. Right now, I think Titan just delaying the inevitable as Puck's still in a very strong position, now on 4 bases, and if Titan's not able to get into a strong macro lead, continue with this pressure, I feel like he's still losing this game.
Yeah, what's very interesting right now is if you take a look at the food tab, it's 177 compared to 166, but if you take a look at the army resources, And Puck is almost double his opponent in both aspects. So that is very, really, really disheartening. As we now see 71 drones from Titan. Meanwhile, 55 drones and probes from Puck. So Puck having a much larger army, but he won't be able to replenish his units nearly as quickly. The Hydralisks are not upgraded at all. So 0-0 upgrades compared to 3-3-0 upgrades on those Stalkers. And I think it may just be those upgrades, as Puck has a larger standing army and his units are more powerful.
Yeah, a lot of different tech coming from Titan. He's got the Banelings, he got the Hydras, he actually got an Infestation pit, and he got the energy upgrade on that, and now going for that Hive, and I feel like he's going to try to get Broodlords, but he's going to be too late here, as Puck, 199 compared to the 190 of Titan, as he's trying to macro up here to defend against this push, but I feel like Puck could very easily win with this push. He hasn't taken very much damage the entire game, and now his all of his work macroing and defending against those drops is going to pay off in a big, strong push.
Yeah, here you go. Stalkers are splitting up. Infestors need to get off some fungal growths. There is no Banelings for actual splash damage, so only fungal growths being used. Corruptors focusing down the Colossi, and Roaches and Hydra is now battling it out, and it looks like another fungal growth may be coming in just a moment, as the Infestors are now low on energy, and Titan now really behind on food count, but down by 50, and it's really those upgrades and Titan losing to Puck here on Daybreak.